In video editing, audio processing is just as important as visuals. This video will introduce several practical audio editing techniques, including adjusting volume, removing background noise, and automatically balancing background music. The quickest way to adjust volume is directly on the timeline. Click the clip you want to adjust, then move your mouse over the white line on the audio track. Drag it up or down to change the volume. To reset the volume, right-click the clip and select Reset Volume Level. You can also double-click the clip, go to the Audio tab, then under the Tools section, click Volume Fade to make adjustments. You can drag the two sliders at the bottom of the interface to quickly add fade-in or fade-out effects to the audio clip. For more precise volume adjustments on specific clips, hold Control and add keyframes on the timeline. For example, if you want the volume to gradually increase from a certain point, add a keyframe at the start and end positions and adjust accordingly.
This built-in AI assistant can give advice on.
To delete a keyframe, hover over it while holding Control and click when the trash icon appears. For more basic concepts and usage of keyframes, you can refer to this video. Sometimes the audio levels of different clips may be inconsistent. To even out the volume across multiple clips, use the Normalize function. Click the button at the top left of the timeline to open the audio mixer interface. You'll see volume sliders for each track. Find the track you want to adjust and click the Normalize button at the bottom. The software will analyze the audio and adjust all clips on the selected track to a consistent volume level. Note that this function requires multiple audio clips on the track. If you want to manually adjust the volume for an entire track, place the playhead over clips on that track, then drag the volume slider up or down to increase or decrease the volume of all clips at once. During filming, the recording environment may not be ideal, resulting in unclear audio or excessive background noise.
Hi everybody, I'm David Morgan. Thanks for joining me for the CyberLink webinar on all.
In such cases, you can use the AI audio denoise feature to remove unwanted noise. Double-click the clip, go to the Audio tab, then under Enhance, click AI audio denoise. After selecting the audio type, the software will automatically analyze the clip and apply recommended adjustments. You can use the preview option below to switch between fixed and original to compare and manually fine-tune the settings.
Hi everybody, I'm David Morgan. Thanks for joining me for the CyberLink webinar on all the best new features of the drone.
Click Apply to apply the changes.
Hi everybody, I'm David Morgan. Thanks for joining me for the CyberLink webinar on all.
Additionally, PowerDirector provides tools for enhancing vocals, removing wind noise, and reducing reverb, which you can use flexibly depending on your material. When adding background music, you may encounter situations where the track length doesn't match the project length. For example, it's just slightly shorter than the end of the project. In this case, you can use the Smart Fit for Duration feature, which analyzes the audio and automatically remixes it to fit the desired length. Select the audio clip, then in the Tools tab, click Smart Fit for Duration. In the interface, you can choose to adjust the length to the playhead position, the end of the project, or a custom length. Click OK to save the settings, and the music will automatically remix to the specified length. The white waveform lines on the clip indicate the remix connection points. You can also adjust it directly on the timeline. Hold Shift and move your mouse to the edge of the music clip. When the cursor changes to this icon, drag the clip to the desired length. The software will automatically analyze and remix the audio. When the music overpowers dialogue, manually adjusting volume clip by clip can be tedious. You can use the audio ducking feature to automatically lower the music volume where dialogue occurs. Select the music clip on the timeline, then open the audio ducking interface. In the interface, there are a few settings you can adjust. Sensitivity controls how the software detects dialogue or narration. Ducking level decides how much the music volume is lowered, and fade and out duration sets how quickly the volume goes down and comes back up. Once everything is set, click Apply, and the software will automatically lower the music whenever it detects narration or dialogue.
Now let's see how we can make our videos more eye-catching. Let's see what advice the Copilot has for us.